We're here at Armageddon 2019 in Wellington. We're going to have a look around and see what nerd and pop culture looks like this year, see what's happening with cosplay, what's happening with anime, what's happening with video games. Let's check it out. They think that I don't know anything, but this is my game. We're going to bring this home, mate.
Yeah,
this is my game face. All right, kiddies, how are we doing this? For anyone who doesn't know, who are you?
Yeah, the Kratos from the God of War 4.
Did you make this costume yourself?
Half and half. The weapon's all me.
What is it that you get out of cosplaying?
For every person, it's different. It really is.
For you?
For me, I do struggle with social pressure and a little bit of social anxiety being around tons of people. So dressing up, I'm not really me. I'm in character. It's so much fun. It really is. Just that you're not really you. You are somebody else. You get in that character, you live in it all day.
Whoa. Run away. No, come back on point. Don't. Doomfist, do not run away. Woohoo! Can't you get all my goals? I didn't get play of the game though. Hello. It must be hot in there. Can I get these, please? $6! These better be the best Cheetos that have ever been made. They're not. What's your name?
Allison.
And what's your name?
Matthew.
Okay, so it's not a new thing to wear anime characters on clothes, but correct me if I'm wrong, but this is hentai frames, right?
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Just...
That's porn, yeah.
I assumed that there was like going to be a modicum of subtlety to it, but no, just straight up, the sign is hentai clothes. Would you wear that?
I actually have one.
Okay, the next question then. Why would you wear that?
I don't know, it's funny.
For the fashion. The hoodie and the sweatpant combination.
You gotta put it together. Yeah.
It's the height of class, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Our last conversation was just so thrilling. I just couldn't pass up this opportunity to chat with you again. Well, just thank you so much for that insight. Have a great day. So Chaz, you're the author of these LGBT-themed children's books, right?
Myself and Adam Reynolds, we're the co-founders of Promised Land Tales, which is a series of LGBT-inclusive children's books, yeah.
Do you think it means a lot to people in the queer community to come to an event like this and see you guys representing the community in this sphere?
I think so, yeah. I mean, we have had people come around and go, oh my God, there's something queer. Like, they kind of run over to the stand. And like, we had someone yesterday who just went, I need this. So it's, yeah, interesting when there are lots of stands with products, but they come over to your stand and they're like, I have to have this book. So, yeah.
They are such awesome books. So thank you so much for your work. I love them. Promise me you won't go near a storm drain. Oh, I regret this immediately! Can we stop? I want to stop now!